Hey y'all, it's Taryn. Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another styling video. So in this video, I am showing you 8 really cute fall looks. So if you're not new here, then you know, last year I did a series called Style Saturdays, where on Saturday I would style pieces I already own in my closet, so we weren't spending any money. We were sort of reimagining pieces and getting new outfits out of things that maybe we didn't envision for that look. I love Style Saturday. A lot of y'all really like it. It's a nice way, again, to use pieces you already own. So I thought I would do that, but for fall, and also it's not on a Saturday. It's a Style Tuesday, I guess. All of the 8 outfits as well are using pieces that I already own. I will try to find the item or similar ones and link them down below. But as with Style Saturday, I encourage you not to spend money, but maybe look through your closets and see what you have and if you can recreate these looks using pieces you already own. I still want to see them, so we're going to use the same hashtag as we did for Style Saturday. So it will be Style Saturday with Taryn. I just like to see what y'all come up with. And a lot of times, honestly, I use your ideas as well for everyday looks for myself. So I hope that you enjoy this video. Before we get into it, today's video is sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online community. They have thousands of classes, y'all. Everything from animation and creative writing to leadership and management, even marketing. So let's take a look at the marketing category. This one with Kat Collette is really, really helpful for me growing your creative business through Instagram. Hence why it's helpful for me, because YouTube, Instagram, social media is my job at the moment. There's even one, check this out, y'all, TikTok marketing. Yonash teaches how to grow your following on the platform. A lot of helpful hints as well. If you're looking to get started on social media and you're not really sure where to begin, then Skillshare can help. Again, I will say this all the time, thousands of classes. So I have a really good deal for y'all. The first 1,000 people to click the link in my description box will receive a 1-month free trial to Skillshare Premium. So please be sure to check it out. Again, even if social media is not your career or job of choice, there's so many other things there as well. Are we ready for the outfits? I only did 8 this time. I wanted to do 10, and I thought 10's a lot. Like, that's a lot of time that y'all are spending just watching me pose in outfits. So we're doing 8 this go round, but let me know if you like it and we can most certainly do another, like, part 2, because there's so many ideas that I have for outfits. So I hope you enjoy it. Let's get into it. First look we have, we'll probably go through these pretty quick as well because there's a lot of them. So we have these Old Navy joggers. They're like a sweatshirt cargo style jogger. Love them, super comfortable. Actually, this light wash denim jacket is also from Old Navy. And then the t-shirt underneath, y'all, it says "What up, boo?" Also from Old Navy. So now that I think about it, pretty much this whole outfit is from Old Navy. The sneakers are from Kato Fashions. I hauled them in a video not long ago, and I've worn them a couple of times. I'm breaking them in. They're not super comfortable yet, but they're bearable. Like, I can wear them somewhere, but we're working on it. They're super cute though. This whole outfit is a very casual, easy way to do fall. The joggers, you could switch out for leggings if that's your thing, or jeans. You know, you could switch and do different things with this outfit, but for me, this one may be one of my favorites. For this next outfit, we're gonna use the same light wash denim jacket from Old Navy, but we're doing it, we're not wearing it, obviously, as you can tell. So these leggings are the brand Mono B. I'm pretty sure I got them in a fashion box. This leopard print black sweatshirt I got from Tea for the Soul. It is the softest inside. It's so comfortable. I wanted some sort of graphic on top, and I felt like the black on black with the leopard was really cute. So I just tied the denim jacket around my waist, and then I'm wearing the tried and true Walmart white sneakers. I mean, how many times have you seen them in a video? They were less than 15 bucks. This outfit, super cute. I just liked the idea. Like, the graphic up top I thought was really, really cute. Plus the leggings are super comfortable. We're gonna stick to the same leggings. So I have these boots. I've had them for years and I'm never really sure how to style them because I feel like jeans are a little bit bulky with them. So we went with the leggings, and this is also very comfortable. These boots have more of a gray tone to them, but they're lined with this like super soft furry fabric. And then this orange pullover I got from Bass Pro Shops, I wanna say a few months ago. I bought it in the summertime, but I felt like it would be good for winter. And I'm so glad that I did. I love the burnt orange color. It's longer. It's a little bit shorter in the front, longer in the back, but it's longer in the front. So if you don't love things higher waisted or higher cut, I guess, or cropped, if you're gonna wear jeans or leggings or something, then something like this is really a good thing for you. This outfit, y'all. Okay, so I love a good flare jean. These are black, super high-waisted flare jeans. I bought these from Universal Standard. So they were pricey, if I remember correctly. I did a video with them, but I think that the black is just really, really nice. And then this plaid, it's definitely a flannel material from Kato Fashions. I realized as I was shooting this video that you're looking at that this top has pockets. I just thought it was a thicker shirt, but it's not. It has pockets, so it's meant to be, well, you can style it, I guess, more as a over, like outerwear type thing, or you could wear it by itself. So it is a thicker material. The hat is from a shop called Shop 1962. A friend of mine, Jasmine, owns it. I just liked the black hat with the colorful plaid and then the black jeans. And then my black booties are from Chic Soul. They have a slit up the front. I think these booties are the cutest, most comfortable, easy to get into booties because they have that opening in the front. So you literally just slide your foot in. There's no reaching down, twisting your ankle to get in, trying like issues pulling it up. These are just really, really nice. And they look cute. They're very sleek. And I like that the slit is quite a bit different look for a booty. On to outfit number five. We're gonna also do plaid. This one's a little bit different. So this plaid top is from Walmart. It's a thinner material. It is more of a blousey type material. So this one, if it's super cold outside, you probably should throw something on over it. But I left the sleeves long versus rolling them to show you if I were to wear this in the cooler months, then this is how it would look. I like the plaid, the yellows and the purples in it. I thought that was pretty. And then I paired it with these super skinny black jeans from Torrid. And then these boots are Ralph Lauren, like biker-ish boots. I don't know if I love the scrunchy ankle with the boots on me. I know it's like super in and I see so many people doing it. So we're trying it in this look because it's just so much easier than trying to figure out how you can fix the bottom of your jeans. This outfit could also be my favorite, though it's very casual. But for some reason, this is Taryn in a nutshell in cooler months. Like very, not oversized, but a little bit baggier, comfortable, this is me. So these are those charcoal-ish wash cropped jeans from Target. I have styled these so many ways and I am so glad that I bought them that day. And then this shacket is from Nordstrom, yes, but it's the brand BP. I do think I got it a size or two too large. It's just very oversized on me. So I front tucked it a little bit in the front to show you what that could look like. But I liked the green color. So half is green, the other half is a green plaid. I own so many shackets, by the way. So do we want to see a video just styling shackets? Because that could be something as well. And then I threw on a pair of Converse. Let's do a little bit of a skirt. So this skirt is from Shein. I love the vibrant blue of it. I love the accordion style that it's flowy. Just the pop of color is so pretty to me. So I opted to use the same Old Navy What Up Boo t-shirt. I just tucked it in. Same white Walmart sneakers. And then I threw on this Target cardigan. The brand is Ava and Viv. I just thought, you know what? This is what people are doing now. Like the skirts with the sneakers are very, very in, especially for summertime. So let's move on and see if I can use it for fall, like as a transition skirt. I think it's really cute. I was very comfortable in this and the flowiness of the skirt was very fun. I did take the cardigan off too and show you what it looks like without the cardigan. So maybe if it's still warm where you live, like it is where I live, then this is what it looks like without the cardigan as more of a summer look. And last but certainly not least, we have this set. So I got this from Walmart, two separate trips, but I ended up buying the hoodie one time and the pants another time. I just liked the dark gray. I threw it on with a pair of white sneakers, those same Walmart ones. It's a hoodie with shorter sleeves and then more of like a wide leg, elastic band drawstring pants. I do think, okay, I washed these pants after I got them, and I think that one leg is shorter than the other one. I may need to stretch it out a little bit more. Like when I look back at this video, I think it's a little bit short on one leg, but this is a very casual, easy way to look put together when it's a little bit cooler outside. And that is a wrap on this video. I hope that you found something that you can see from your own closet, like you can see pieces that you already own and recreate them. Again, use that hashtag Style Saturday with Taryn. Don't forget, comment down below and let me know if you wanna see a part two. We could do part two, three, four, five, like throughout fall and into winter, maybe even into spring. I feel like these videos are so helpful for me as well. I look back at them, no joke. I look back at Style Saturdays and think, okay, I have this sweater. I know I styled it in a video. Let me see how I did it. And I use my own like style for inspiration. So I hope that you liked it. If you did, thumbs up, subscribe, you know the drill. Don't forget, check out the link in the description box to Skillshare. And thank you again to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. And I'll see y'all in my next one. Bye.